the states which can, you know, be the surprise factor?
I think Tamil Nadu will be a very important state which will be a surprise factor.
As will Andhra.
Uttar Pradesh.
As will Andhra.
Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Uttar Pradesh. Well, you know, in each of these states, you know, it could, we've always spoken about, Nitish seems to be the only certainty. You know, Chandrababu Naidu, Mayawati, and Jayalalitha.
Nitish is a certainty as far as the outcome goes, but what he's going to do after the outcome is not a certainty.
Okay. Yeah.
And let's see, we have a bit of breaking news here right now. I think Dhanya Rajendran has news joining us right now. Jayalalitha apparently has confirmed to the BJP she will begin the process of talks and negotiations if they cross 150. Dhanya, what is the inside story on that?
Well, that's what we've been told, that BJP leaders LK Advani and Narendra Modi had been working overtime to get in touch with the AIADMK chief to convince her to come to the NDA. But apparently she's told them that if they cross the 150 mark, then she will have talks with them. She's also told them that any talks can happen only after the results today. Because Arnab, there is a sense in the AIADMK camp that perhaps they may not do as well as expected, and the DMK could walk away with a number of seats. So the AIADMK camp really is playing it very cautiously at the moment. They've in fact told the BJP that any discussion can start only if the BJP by itself crosses the 150 mark. So today the BJP can get back to the AIADMK only if they do that. What other option does J. Jayalalitha have really? That's a baffling question, because the third front, will they cobble up numbers? She anyway cannot go back to the Congress now. So the BJP really has to get back to her at this moment.